Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Gene, its nature, expression and regulation. In that, we are studying topic properties of genetic code. We all know that whenever a protein is synthesized, for example insulin, then the instructions are present on mRNA, which is the genetic code. Today we'll be studying what are the properties of this genetic code on mRNA. During the synthesis of any protein, the basic mechanism goes that on mRNA, which is single-stranded, has codons on it, and these codons basically genetic code. Whenever we study protein synthesis, on the surface of mRNA, we know that there are codons present, and those codons are nothing but in triplets, and these codons basically match or mix or attach themselves with anticodons present on tRNA. When the codon-anticodon mixture, or you can say mixing, take place, then a protein is synthesized. So during protein synthesis, mRNA, that is a messenger RNA, transfer RNA, ribosomes come together and form your protein or polypeptide. But there are certain genetic codes or codons present on mRNA, and these codons or codes or mRNA had certain properties. Firstly, there are 64 codons present on mRNA, which together code for 20 different amino acids, which could be arginine, methionine, any of those. Now, the properties of these codons are that the code is universal, which means that one particular codon, if it is AUG, then it will code for one particular amino acid. One codon cannot code for multiple amino acid. It can code for only one. The code is commaless. When I say the code is commaless, it means that after a triplet of codon, there won't be continuity of codon just adjacent to it. The codons will be distinct and at their particular places. The code is non-overlapping. There are never a chances that two different codons are similar and they are just adjacent to each other. That similarity is never seen in genetic code. Start codon is always AUG. And AUG, start codon, as we all know codons are universal, will always code for amino acid methionine. Whereas stop codon can be different. Sometimes it is UGA, sometimes it is UA, depending. Lastly, the codons have polarity. So whenever you read that triplet codons on mRNA, they will be read in certain direction, that is from 5' to 3' direction, in the direction of protein synthesis. The properties of genetic code are as follows. Now total there are 64 triplet codons on mRNA which code for 20 different amino acids. The code can be universal in nature. Secondly, the code is commaless. That is, there are no permutation, combinations or commas in a particular genetic code. properties of genetic code are that this code is non-overlapping. It means same nitrogen bases are never used for a particular triplet codon. The codon, or you can say mRNA for protein synthesis, will have a start codon for protein synthesis initiation and a stop codon to stop that protein synthesis. Now basically on the 5' end of mRNA, start codon is present, and this start codon in eukaryotes is always AUG, and AUG codes for amino acid methionine, whereas the stop codon can be UA, UAG or UGE. These three are various stop codons which can be present. One of these stop codons is present. Lastly, the genetic code has polarity, that is, it is read in certain direction, that is, from the orientation of mRNA, that is, in 5' direction to 3' direction. This is the way which protein are synthesized. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about the properties of genetic code. And these properties of genetic code are important when you synthesize those proteins or whenever those traits are formed inside your body. For example, for the synthesis of insulin, hormones, all of them, this trait or this genetic code is important, and mutations in them can cause any disease, which could be autoimmune also. I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.